Please subscribe to this channel and also tap the notification bell in order for you not to miss out on any of our videos. The head of state, Paul Biya, and his wife celebrated their mahogany wedding anniversary on April 23rd, commemorating 27 years of living together. The commemoration of the 27 years of Paul and Chantal Biya's life was celebrated just like last year, in a context marked rather by the coronavirus pandemic. It was indeed on April 23, 1994, when she was only 24 years old and he, Paul Biya, was 61, that the young lovebirds Paul and Chantal then joined in marriage. Chantal Pulchérie Vigouroux had just said yes forever to the force of experience, thus making her the First Lady of Cameroon. The new First Lady will be solemnly presented to Cameroonians at a reception organized in the evening at the Palace of Unity on the occasion of the national holiday of 20th May 1994. Indeed, many corroborating sources indicate that following the death in 1992 of Madame Jeanne-Irene Biya, the first wife of the head of state, President Paul Biya, will be urged by his relatives in the palace of Etudi and Vomeka, his native village in the southern region, to give the country a new first lady. It is in this vein that women, from the offspring of the politico-administrative elites who structure the state in Cameroon, will be proposed to him. But the latter thwarted all predictions, choosing a young and beautiful Métis woman in her 20s at the time. A choice that will also divide opinions. On the other hand, we will also have those who felt that there is no need to discuss the choice of the president because it falls within the domain of the private sector. And while on the other side, there were those more numerous besides those who were in this second marriage of a political act which went beyond the sphere of intimate. What will be the worth to the first lady to be at the time admired, coveted and feared, especially as her way of being in the public sphere would henceforth shed light on the new configurations in Cameroon of politics and of a civil society prescribed by the international texts. Chantal Biya rejoices the popular classes who find her natural, ordinary and spontaneous. At the same time, certain feverish whippersnappers will reproach her as much for what she is and what she does, especially since she did not come from this class of people from above. This is certainly what will make many observers say that by choosing to marry Chantal Pulchérie Vigouroux, President Paul Biya thus demonstrated his open-mindedness and above all, his freedom to act in a political context where secular and scholarly analyses of his independence on those around him were going well. Beyond all these hypotheses, it is obvious that this choice was delightful for one and the same reason. This union was not dictated by a political strategy, but was indeed the fruit of an emotional choice. He had thus just chosen his right arm, and the facts will prove that President Biya of the Republic, especially since today, the First Lady has positioned herself through her actions not only as a mother who has also known how to help her children, but also as a mother to everyone who is true muse to the international level. As a proof of this, we take the various organizations that she heads and above all the various international recognitions that she has garnered over time.